Hello friends, welcome back. Today we would be learning an extremely important topic. If you remember, in one of my previous tutorials I had explained how to automate data entry on an Internet Explorer browser using Excel macros. On that tutorial I received a number of queries where people asked me how to do the same on Google Chrome browser. In this tutorial I would be explaining how to automate data entry using Excel macros on the Google Chrome browser. So let's begin. Now, Excel VBA macros by itself won't be able to automate Chrome browser. For achieving automation on Chrome browser using Excel macros, we will need the help of Selenium. So, for achieving data entry automation on Chrome browser, we will need to install VBA support for Selenium, which you would be able to get it from this location which I am highlighting right now. I'll show you this web page. This is the website. Please take a note of this website. From here you would be able to download this thing, Selenium Basic 2.0.9.exe. You will have to download this exe. Just click on this link and the download would begin. I am not downloading it as I have already downloaded it. Once the download gets completed, you'll have this Selenium Basic exe file in your local system. The Selenium exe looks like this. It is a simple exe file. Once this is downloaded, you have to double click it and get the installation started. The installation is very simple. You have to just click on the next button, accept the license agreement, next, next. At this point you'll see where the Selenium is getting installed. Please make a note of this path where Selenium is getting installed. This is very important. I'll let you know in few minutes why this path is important. Do not forget to make a note of this path. And finally click on the install button. Since I have already installed it, I am not clicking on the install button. I am cancelling it, but please do complete the installation by clicking on the install button. So this was the installation part. We are done with that. And now we would open the Excel file and start writing the macro to automate data entry on Google Chrome browser. So let's open the Excel file. So we will open a fresh Excel file. So this is a blank Excel file. And here we would go to the place where we would be actually writing the code. For that, press the keys Alt F11. You have already seen this in my previous tutorials. So this is the place where we would be writing the code. One very important point before writing the code is, here we have to do some settings so that the macro will know that we are using Selenium to do the execution. For that we'll have to add a reference of Selenium. So here, go to tool, references, and here you have to select Selenium. I'll show you. Here it is. It is Selenium type library. So put a check over there and click on OK. So now we are good. We have included the Selenium library. So now we are ready to write the code which would be actually automating the data entry on the Google Chrome browser. But we'll perform one step before actually writing the code. That is, if you remember a few minutes earlier, I told you to store the path where Selenium is getting installed. So now we'll move to that path and I'll show you what needs to be done. So this is the path where Selenium is stored on my system. I'm assuming you have noted the path of your system where Selenium has been installed. And if you carefully observe over here, here you could find something called Chrome driver. Now those who are aware of Selenium, they would be knowing that Selenium execution on Chrome browser depends on this Chrome driver. So this Chrome driver is mandatory. Not only it is mandatory to have the Chrome driver, but the Chrome driver version should also be appropriate. Now if I just double click on this Chrome driver over here, here I could see it's 2.45. Now this 2.45 version should be compatible with the Chrome browser version which I have on my system. So let's check what version of Chrome browser I have on my system. So if I look at my Chrome browser, if I select these three dots towards the right hand top side, here if I go to help about Google Chrome, Here I would be able to see the version, and the version on my system is 71.0. Now this 71.0 should be compatible with the Chrome driver exe, which is 2.45. Now from where we would come to know. So for that, you have to make a note of this website which I am showing you right now. It is chromedriver.chromium.org.downloads. This is the website, and here you will find the compatibility. Now it is showing that Chrome driver 2.45 is compatible with Chrome browser versions v7272, and if you remember, my version was something 71. So this Chrome driver 2.45 would support my Chrome browser. So here, if you just scroll down, you have the different versions of the driver, and with that the browser version which it supports. So based on your Chrome browser version, you will have to download the Chrome driver. Suppose you are also using the latest version of the Chrome browser and you need this Chrome driver 2.45. for downloading it, you have to just click over here. So this website would open, and I would suggest if you are using Windows, then use this Chrome driver win32.zip. Just click on it and it would be available in your folder as a zip. You'll have to just extract it. And for people who would be wondering, like, my Chrome browser version is not the latest, so you will have to find which Chrome driver.exe supports your Chrome browser, and here in this URL you will have to change the version of the Chrome driver which you need. For example, if somebody says he or she is using Chrome browser v69, for which the appropriate version is 2.42, to get the Chrome driver 2.42, what you have to do is, here on this URL, just change the digits. Like here it is 2.45, it is showing, change it to 2.42, hit enter. So this kind of a page would come up, and here you would see Chrome driver win32zip. So you could just download this. For initiating the download, you have to just click on this link and the download would begin. Once the download is complete, you'll have this kind of a zip file. What you have to do is just do a right click, extract all, extract. It will take few seconds. And once it is done, you'll have this Chrome driver exe. Now what you have to do is, depending on the version, you have downloaded the Chrome driver, you have extracted it. Now what you have to do is copy this Chrome driver which you just downloaded and extracted based on the appropriate version, and go to the path where Selenium has been installed and just replace this. You already have a default Chrome driver over here, you have to replace it. So now it has got replaced. Now this step is mandatory, do not forget to do that, because when you would be installing Selenium, at that point in time the default Chrome driver would be getting installed at this place. That driver would be outdated, so you will have to update this Chrome driver. If you won't do this, then the Selenium execution through the Excel macro would not work. I repeat, it would not work, it would fail. So this step is very important. Select the appropriate Chrome driver version based on the Chrome browser version and do a replace at the path where Selenium has been installed. So at this point, all the configurations are in place, and now we'd go back to our Excel and start writing the code. For that, I'll do a right click over here, insert module. Here we would actually write the code. The syntax goes like this. First of all, we give the name of the sub. Now this name is of your choice, you could give any name. I have given the name as Chrome Auto. Here the first sentence, we are defining an object of type WebDriver. People who are familiar with Selenium, they would be aware of this WebDriver. For people who are new to it, do not worry, this is just a syntax. We are just telling that this OBJ object is of type WebDriver. And now we are using this object in the next line as obj.start space, and within double inverted quotes Chrome, which means we would be initiating the Chrome browser, then this comma and then this double inverted quotes. in the next line, we are actually navigating to the website using the same OBJ object, and this time we are using obj.get, and within double inverted quotes, any website of your choice. So let's just execute this and see what happens. I'm placing my breakpoint over here so that the execution will halt over here, and to execute it, I'm just clicking this green button at the top. I do that and let's see what happens. So you can see the Chrome browser has launched, and now you could see over here Chrome is being controlled by automated test software. It is giving you a notice, and here you could see it has launched the page successfully. Now on this page, we would be making some entries, like we would be picking the value from the Excel sheet and inserting them into these text boxes. So let's again go back. Now I had kept a breakpoint because of which it has halted over here. So now we would start to enter something on the opened web page. To make entries on these fields, I should be knowing some internal properties, internal HTML properties of these fields. For example, first name, I need to know some properties of this first name. So I just take my mouse over there, do a right click, select inspect. This kind of a window would come up. Here you have this arrow thing. Go to that arrow, do a left click, and now drop it on the first name because we need to know the properties of first name. And here it is highlighted in blue color below, and if you would see the name property, like the name property of this text box is first name. So we would use this name property and try to make an automated data entry on this first name field. So I just copy this. Now I'll use this in my code. I'm just copying it over here. Now I'll use this obj object again. Obj dot, now I'll use find element by name because we had picked up the name property. So obj find element by name within brackets, within double inverted quotes, the name which we had copied, which is first name over here. I'm removing it from here because I have used it over here. Dot send keys, and here within double inverted quotes, the value which we want to see on that field. So I am just clicking on this stop button, the square button on the top, to stop the execution. Now I'll click this green button to re-execute this, and if everything works fine, then test would be seen in the first name text box. So I am clicking this green button and let's see what happens. You could see the browser has launched. Now it would navigate to the web page, and now you would see it was pretty quick, but you could see test has been entered. So we have successfully made the data entry of test in the first name text box. Similarly, we would need the properties of these other fields to make data entry in these fields. So I'll move back to the code, and now I'll write the code for the rest of the fields. I had already fetched the property, so I'm directly using it. You have to use the same procedure as I had shown it for the first name. So here, if you would see the second line, here we are finding the last name, which is this field. So the name of this surname field is last name. So we are using find element by name, last name, send keys as test. Now if you would see the next two elements, which are mobile number or email address and new password. Now I have used find element by ID. Now this is the beauty of Selenium. Selenium gives you a lot of options, like by which locator you want to identify the element. If you just do this obj.find, you could see these are the ways in which you could uniquely identify the element. So you could pick up the appropriate value of the HTML from the HTML of the page and you could use it. For example, here I have used the IDs. So I have used the ID over here. I will show you the ID of this field. This is the mobile number field. So if I do a right click, inspect, same steps, this arrow, I just place it on the mobile number field. Here if you would see, the ID is U0O. So same thing, I am using it over here. Similarly, the ID of the next field is U0V. So let's try to execute this. So once again, I'll stop the execution by clicking this square on the top. And now once again, I am clicking this green button, and let's see what happens this time. Once again, you see the browser has launched, and let's see what happens now. The page has opened, and now you could see the values were correctly entered. These fields were correctly recognized by the code, and these values which I had written here have been made on these fields. So at this point, though the data entry has been done, but our intention is to pick up the value from the Excel sheet. These are all hard-coded values, but what if we want to pick up the value from the Excel sheet? For example, I have these fields over here, like I just entered test in cells A1, A2, some numbers in A3, and some random string in A4. Now, if I want to pick up these values from these cells and make a data entry, what changes are required in the code? It is very simple. I have shown this in my previous tutorials. So here we'll have to replace this test. So this test, for example, assume it is coming from cell A1. So the code will be this workbook dot sheets within brackets, the name of the sheet from where we are picking the value. In our case, it is sheet 1 dot range. We are picking the value from A1. So A1 dot value. Similarly, this thing is coming from A2. So I'll just copy this thing, paste it in the next field. Here I would just change the index to A2. Next is A3. Finally, A4. That's it. Now we are actually picking the values from this sheet 1. The name of the sheet is sheet 1. So we have used sheet 1 over here, and we have mentioned the cells from which we are picking the data. So once again, I'll stop the execution. And now, once again, I am clicking this green button, and let's see what happens this time. Again, the Chrome browser has launched. It is navigating to the page, and you could see it has once again entered the values. This time, if you would see, these are not hard-coded values. We are picking the values from the data sheet. So this is how we do automated data entry on the Chrome browser with the help of Excel macros. It is a combination of Excel macro and Selenium. So this is how we automate data entry on the Chrome browser. If you have any questions, do let me know. I would be happy to help. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you like my videos, I request you to please subscribe to my channel so that you would be updated with the latest videos I would be uploading. Friends, I would see you in my next tutorial. Thanks for joining. Goodbye.